The president has rightly bragged about the tax cuts and feels that in the midterm election it's going to be a big, big issue. We thought we'd talk with Elaine Parker, president of the Job Creators Network Foundation. They played a huge role in getting the tax cut legislation passed last year. Ms. Parker, thank you very much for coming on the show. I appreciate it.
Hi, Larry. Thanks so much for having me tonight.
Isn't it fascinating, Ms. Parker, how at one time the tax cut bill was very unpopular, and then when people open up their paychecks, whoa, their paychecks were bigger. All of a sudden, the sentiment has shifted, and now the tax cut bill is extremely popular.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. Over 4 million employees have received raises and bonuses. But even better is that every single American is getting more money in their paycheck if they get a paycheck. And that's the reason why the tax cuts have gotten so popular.
I've been talking about your website, taxcutswork.com, and how people can go and talk about their own personal stories. Because, you know, if you watch cable, and I watch a lot of it, Ms. Parker, when the tax cut bill got passed, you heard people like Nancy Pelosi referring to the benefits as crumbs. Many people were predicting the corporations were not going to give the money to workers, when in fact the opposite has happened.
You know, that's very true. That's a great point. And our Tax Cuts Work campaign is a national campaign to highlight those stories of small business owners and their employees and how they are benefiting from the tax cuts. And just to give you a story, you know, a family making about $50,000 a year under this new tax bill is saving about $1,200 a year. And that could be a year's worth of cell phone bills in my house, or even an extra mortgage payment for some people. It is a big deal for middle-class families. It is not crumbs.
I'm talking with Elaine Parker. She is president of the Job Creators Network Foundation. Their website, taxcutswork.com, is taxcutswork.com. Ms. Parker, not one Democrat voted for the tax cuts last year. We have this, of course, big election coming up. It seems to me that the Republican Party ought to make hay out of the fact that not a single Democrat voted for the tax cut. And as we mentioned a moment ago, the bill is becoming increasingly popular.
You know, unfortunately, that is true, Larry. The Democrats oppose the tax cut. And, you know, cutting taxes for small business and middle-class families should not be a partisan issue. And that's why on our website at taxcutswork.com, your listeners can go to the website and they can actually calculate their tax savings. We have a calculator there. And they can sign a petition to tell Congress that they want to keep their tax savings. And they can tell their congressional members to please protect their tax savings.
I heard someone, a Democrat, yesterday, Ms. Parker, on cable say, well, these tax cuts, quote, are only temporary, close quote.
Well, the fact is we are very hopeful this year that we will see the tax cuts become permanent for everyone, and that we will see some changes. It wasn't a perfect bill, but it was a necessary bill, and everybody at every level got a tax cut. And most importantly, the 30 million small businesses out there and the 60 million employees out there, actually everybody who gets a paycheck, got a tax cut.
One of the things I found interesting about the tax cut bill, Ms. Parker, is that it eliminated the deduction of state and local taxes. A lot of very wealthy people were upset about the elimination of the deduction for state and local taxes. I feel that if Donald Trump did not self-fund, he probably would not have been able to do that, because a lot of his buddies probably picked up the phone, Ms. Parker, and called him and said, what are you doing? He didn't need their money. He was not beholden to these wealthy donors the way, for example, Hillary was.
You know, that's true, Larry, and the fact of the matter is we haven't seen tax relief like this in more than 30 years, and small business has never seen the kind of tax relief that they got this last December, and we're very proud that we were part of that fight in fighting for the 85 million people that depend on the success of small business.
Ms. Parker, I just read a poll that still shows for the first time in several years, young people now feel they're going to do better than their parents. During the Obama years, a minority of young people felt they were going to do better than their parents. That was the first time, I think, in the history of this country since that question has been taken, where young people did not feel they were going to do better than their parents. Now young people feel they're going to do better than their parents. I feel that it's in part at least because of this tax cut bill.
Well, we're certainly hearing from our members, our small business owners who are our members at the Job Creators Network, that they are optimistic. They are investing in their business, in their employees, and they're growing their businesses. And all that's going to create more jobs for future generations. So I'm not surprised by that poll that you read.
And the sentiment for small businesses, you know, off the charts. First time in years that an overwhelming majority of small business people are very optimistic about the future.
I mean, our members, I can give you an example. We've got a guy who's a cookie manufacturer. He makes 12 million cookies a day in Florida, and he gave all of his employees raises anywhere from $3,000 to $5,000 each, and he is building a new facility in Florida, and he's created some new labeling and packaging so that he can get better distribution internationally. So the cookie business is doing well.
My guest is Elaine Parker, president of the Job Creators Network Foundation. The website is taxcutswork.com. That's taxcutswork.com. And she would be interested in hearing your stories about the tax cut bill and how it's benefited you and benefited your business. Taxcutswork.com. That's taxcutswork.com. Elaine Parker, thank you very much for taking the time. We appreciate it.
Thank you.